largest settlement ever from the Roman Catholic Church for alleged child sex abuse. The Archdiocese of Los Angeles has agreed to pay out, and listen to this number, $880 million to more than 1,300 people.
The settlement could be the final chapter in what has now become a landmark battle of child sex abuse claims dating back decades. It's on behalf of more than 1,300 victims who say they suffered abuse by local Catholic priests and comes after months of negotiations with the Archdiocese. More than 300 priests have been accused in legal documents and public records of sexually abusing minors. The Archdiocese had previously paid $740 million in various settlements, bringing this total payout to more than $1.5 billion. The Archdiocese says it will fund those settlements with investments, assets, reserves, and bank loans. In a statement, attorneys for the alleged victims told CBS News, the massive amount of this settlement reflects the amount of grievous harm done to vulnerable children and the decades of neglect, complicity, and cover-up by the Archdiocese, which allowed known serial predators to inflict this harm. Archbishop Jose Gomez, in a statement, said in part he hoped the settlement would provide some measure of healing.
Now, to that massive settlement by the L.A. Archdiocese, $880 million to settle more than 1,300 child sexual abuse claims. NBC4's Darsha Phillips in studio with us tonight with more. Darsha?
Yeah, Colleen, this is a historic settlement made possible by legislation in Sacramento that allowed victims of clergy abuse a three-year window to file claims that were outside the current statute of limitations. Some of these victims are now elderly and are finally getting some measure of healing from abuse that has marked most of their lives.
The Archdiocese of Los Angeles has agreed to pay a record settlement of $880 million to victims who were sexually abused by local Catholic priests dating back decades. Attorney Morgan Stewart represented some of those victims.
From a standpoint of a survivor carrying a message where, you know, they were 9, 10, 11 abused by a priest and they're grateful to an attorney for 20, 30 years later, bringing them some closure is amazing and heartwarming.
1,353 victims were part of this settlement that included months of negotiations with the Archdiocese. Archbishop Jose Gomez approved the settlement and released a letter to his parishioners saying in part, "I am very sorry for every one of these incidents from the bottom of my heart. My hope is that this settlement will provide some measure of healing for what these men and women have suffered." More than 300 priests who worked in the L.A. Archdiocese over the last several decades have been accused of sexually abusing minors, including Father Michael Baker, who later served time in state prison.
Michael Baker was a priest, notorious, sent away, brought back in, put back into ministry despite the knowledge that he was a risk to parishioners.
Today, the Archdiocese says it has implemented safeguard programs to prevent such abuses from happening.
We train every adult who is going to be in ministry with children or have supervision of children, whether they're an employee or they're a volunteer.
And created a victim's assistance coordinator so people who have suffered abuse in the church have someone to turn to.
We make sure that the appropriate civil authorities are informed. We walk with that survivor to determine what it is they need, what they're seeking, how we can be of support to them.
Something the victims from decades ago didn't have, but helped create because they bravely came forward.
I think there's hope in this moment for those who've been harmed.
Now, the settlement leaves only a few pending lawsuits against the church in Los Angeles. Colleen?
All praise to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. And this video is going to be entitled Vocab Malone. Do a report on these devilish Catholics, you big hypocrite. Do a report on these devilish Catholics, you big hypocrite. And that's you, Vocab Malone, the fathead serpent. Because every time you turn around, he's accusing the Hebrew Israelites of something. Last week or the week before, he was going back and forth with Captain Cesario over him merely saying in the kingdom of heaven, in a righteous world, he mentioned something about he would, you know, do something to the slaves, and this damn devil had a fit. Meanwhile, your own Catholics, right, your people that you derived from, because all Christians, basically, the model of Christianity that you worship right now, that's your father church, the Roman Catholic Church. They got the same white Jesus. They got the same universal doctrine of all people being saved. They have some different tenets. However, you all come from that same Catholic tree. Now, I put a video in the beginning, right, which is like Gail King and other news reporters talking about this largest settlement ever from the Roman Catholic Church for alleged child sex abuse. And this is reported on October 17, 2024, right? Now, before you say that's a hoax, it's made up, that didn't really happen, you got that video off TikTok. Nope. It's literal news. You look it up, you can find it. I looked up settlement in the Roman Catholic Church and victims of abuse. And this is what it says. On October 17th, 2024, the Roman Catholic Archdiocese of Los Angeles agreed to pay $880 million to 1,353 people who accused priests of abusing them as children. A bunch of damn kid touchers, man. Here we are, grown men, and we say that we're going to have slaves in the kingdom, or that we can get women, you know, at a younger age than now, and things going to go back to how they always been. You people blow a head gasket. Namely, Vocab Malone and your Christian punks. You got a lot to say, but when it's your own Christian people, you got nothing to say. Why your mouths closed on this? Why your mouths closed? It's because you're hypocrites, man. That's why. And really, you're just trying to accuse the Israelites. We're tearing you up with this truth. Look here. Victims of clergy sex abuse in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles have announced a settlement of nearly $900 million, almost $1 billion. Over almost 1,400 kids been abused, fondled. You see? And different things by these Roman Catholics. And you know it's way more than that. There's way more kids than that that's been touched. And that's just children. It is the largest payout ever to stem from the Catholic Church's abuse crisis. NPR religion correspondent Jason DeRose joins us now to talk about the settlement and what led to it. And what led to it is you filthy, wicked devils in that damn church. Now, when you go to the word, I'm sorry, when you go to here, I looked up that modern Christianity start with Catholics. By its own reading of history, Roman Catholicism originated with the very beginnings of Christianity. Don't try to say, oh, they use the Apocrypha, or they believe in confession, and this and that. It's a little bit different, a different form of Christianity, but it's the main form of Christianity, and all your other churches spun off from it. From your Baptist to your Calvinists, your Baptists, your Episcopalians, your Seventh-day Adventists. You see, Jehovah's Witnesses, even Islam, all spun off from the Roman Catholic Church. Don't try to get out of it. You got the same white Jesus, and you all preach that same doctrine. When you look up the term Catholicism on the Etymology Online Dictionary, it says faith and practice of the Catholic Church. Check this out. Now, the apostles taught us about this. That is, look at it. It says mid-14th century Catholic of the doctrines of the ancient church. Before the East-West Schism, literally, universally accepted. That's what, when you go into it, Catholicism or Catholic is universal. Universally accepted from French, Catholique, from Church Latin, Catholicus, universal, general. And Catholicism is that doctrine of universalism. Just like what you teach, Vocab Malone. You teach that everybody can be saved. Look down here. With capital C, it was applied by Protestants to the church in Rome by circa 1554 after the Reformation began in England. Look, the general sense of embracing all, universal in English, is from 1550s. Right here we want to get to, right here. Embracing all, universal. And that's what you teach. You teach embracing everybody, right? That's what you guys teach. And you're nothing but a hypocrite, man. Now, first, every time you look around, you're doing a video on trying to catch us in our words, trying to say we planning something or we going to do something. What difference does it matter? If you're talking about the kingdom, when you teach people that, they're going to try to hasten the kingdom. Fuck off already, man. You are a big coward. And you're definitely a coward. And you a big hypocrite, Vocab Malone, and all the rest of you devils. And we've been knew it. More and more, you being exposed all the time. This is Hebrews 4:12. It says, for the word of the Most High is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. The fact that you have not made a peep about this, and you probably won't. Maybe you will now, and other things like it. There's all kind of crimes that Christians do on the regular, and you don't bring them up. All kind of terrorist activities and attacks and different abuse crimes. All kind of nasty, wicked things going on in Christianity, and you never make a peep. You don't make a sound. How can you overlook this? $900 million given to child sex, those that are abused, children that were abused in sex crimes by the heads of the church. By the heads of the church. And not a one of them, you don't hear about them going to jail like that. But you know what? All of them should be destroyed. They should be put to death by the Lord. That's what should happen to them for their crimes. Touching on kids. You see? But you ain't never going to say nothing about it, because you're the devil. And this truth is revealing you more and more. Also, I want to get here. Let's get to Hebrews. Is it 10? Yeah. And you drawing back, Vocab. You supposed to, hey, if you claiming you an apologist and you defend the word, you do this and you do all of that, why you ain't defending the word against the Catholics? Here it is. You come against us for bringing out, reading out of the Apocrypha. But the Catholics read out of the Apocrypha. You ain't said nothing. You a hypocrite, man. Not that there's nothing wrong with the Apocrypha, though. That's the whole problem. But if you're going to come against us, why haven't you come against them? Why haven't you come against them for their stance on homosexuality and all them different things going on, them different preachers? Here it is. None of us have been accused of touching on damn kids. You don't have not one single case. But every time we turn around, here you are trying to accuse us of something. You big hypocrite. Hebrews 10:38. Now the just shall live by faith. But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. You've been drawing back, Vocab. You're holding back your soul from blood. Let's see here. You're being very selective, and you've been you respect of persons. Your main focus is you're trying to condemn the Hebrew Israelites. But you don't want to condemn those of your own world that's doing wickedness and evil. Jeremiah 48:10, you getting on us over a perceived threat. A perceived threat. You perceive us as a threat, so therefore you rebuke us. But a real threat, you ain't saying nothing about. Jeremiah 48:10, cursed be he that doeth the work of the Lord deceitfully. If you ask Vocab Malone, he'll say he's doing the work of the Lord. But you're doing it deceitfully. You got an agenda. We rebuke everybody. We rebuke Israelites, even our own brothers in GMS. We kick guys out, all kind of stuff. We rebuke everybody, all Israelites. We don't come together with nobody. We get on Christians, Muslims, Hindus. We don't give a damn. We'll get on anybody. You, on the other hand, you're a respecter of persons and a hypocrite. Jeremiah 48:10, cursed be he that doeth the work of the Lord deceitfully, and cursed be he that keepeth back his soul from blood. And in this case, we talk about a spiritual sword from blood. You keeping back your spiritual sword. You have remained partial. When your Christian brothers do something that's amiss or awry, you keep your mouth closed. You know why? Again, because you have an agenda and you're a hypocrite, man. This is Job chapter 20, verse 4. Knowest thou not this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment? Right now you think you're on top of the world, Vocab, but you're getting your ass tore up, man. Weekly. By the Hebrew Israelites. Every time, the Most High make you look like a fool. And we didn't forget that you just got revealed recently for being a coward, for taking your video down. Because you got confounded on Isaiah chapter 60 when you was dealing with Captain Tazariah. And there's many things like that. And all you try to do is hurry up and do other videos to cover it up. Nope, you ain't gonna be able to cover it up. We're not gonna let you. We're going to grind you, man. We're going to keep on revealing you more and more through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. No matter how mad you get, you are a hypocrite. That the triumphing of the wicked is short and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment. And the wicked is Esau, Edom, the so-called white man. That's the wicked. Though his excellency mount up to the heavens and his head reach into the clouds, yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? He shall fly away as a dream and shall not be found. Yet he shall be chased away as a vision of the night. The eye also which saw him shall see him no more, neither shall his place any more behold him. And that's what the position you're going to be in, all you Edomites out there. That lofty position that you've been sitting in for all this time, thinking that you cannot be touched, you're going to be brought down, right? And people are going to say, where are those mighty Edomites at? They used to rule the whole earth in wickedness. Because you are the wicked. And we don't care if you don't believe it. We don't care if you get mad. So what? I'm going to read here from the Savior, from the Savior's own words. This is Matthew 7 and verse 1. Judge not that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye met, it shall be measured to you again. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye? You so busy looking at the Hebrew Israelites, you ain't looking at your own house. Y'all, all of Christianity is a mess. You got Christian preachers that's being caught up in, what about T.D. Jakes? He been accused of being in them damn, what's them things called, them freak-offs. You got pastors from the Christian church giving people herpes. Pastors in the Christian church telling people that they got holy milk in their penis. You got Christian pastors going to jail for grifting their congregation, getting prison sentences, and you ain't saying nothing, man. You ain't saying nothing. All the Christian preachers who saying they got holy water or miracle spring water, prayer shawls that can give you special abilities. Crazy Benny Hinn thinking that the Holy Spirit is in his jacket. He can slap you with his jacket and give you the Holy Spirit. Nothing from Vocab Malone. It's quiet on these issues. You're a hypocrite. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye? Or how wilt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of thine eye, and behold, a beam is in thine own eye? Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam out of thine own eye, and then shalt thou see clearly to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye. And I'm not saying, you know, I'm using this scripture as an illustrative point. Sure, the Savior was talking about other things, but it can be used on people like you because you're a hypocrite. You're so busy worrying about the Hebrews, like the Hebrew Israelism, these guys are violent. They push a doctrine that sparks violence, blah, blah, blah. Meanwhile, your own Christian preachers are a bunch of pedophiles, homosexuals, and degenerates of all manner and sorts. And you say nothing, Vocab Malone. You're a big, I won't even say disappointment, because I didn't expect nothing different out of you. You're a devil. Let's get the NLT of that real quick. This is Matthew 7 and 1. Do not judge others and you will not be judged. For you will be treated as you treat others. The standard you use in judging is the standard by which you will be judged. And why worry about a speck in your friend's eye when you have a log in your own? How can you think of saying to your friend, let me help you get rid of that speck in your eye, when you can't see past the log in your own eye? Hypocrite, first get rid of the log in your own eye, then you will see well enough to deal with the speck in your friend's eye. And the point of me reading that is what? Christianity, you punk ass Christian, so worried about the Hebrew Israelites, you need to clean up your own shoddy religion. Bunch of devils, all kind of witchcraft, you know, seances, right? All kind of wicked things going on in that Christian church. And you people still celebrate Christmas and Thanksgiving and Father's Day and Mother's Day, your birthdays, all kind of abominations, idolatry, all kind of wickedness. Wait till December 25th come. All you going to be singing Fa La La with them ugly sweaters on, them stupid pajamas. Anyway, that's it. This is has been Vocab Malone. Do a report on the devilish Catholics, you big hypocrite. And we know that you're not gonna, because you're a coward and a hypocrite.